Welcome to this session. I hope you enjoyed the previous session on effective speaking. And adding on from there, today we are going to discuss public speaking. When we talk about public speaking, there are various ways in which we could develop into public speakers. There are various methods that we could use. So when we talk about the methods of delivery, we talk about reading a manuscript verbatim, which means that you could take up a paper while you are called on the lectern to speak. You have your speech ready with you and you read out from that manuscript. The second one could be that you could memorize it. The third one could be you could speak impromptu. So for instance, if in case you give me a topic, like just a minute is there, so I'll be speaking instantly, developing my content instantly on the basis of my knowledge. The fourth thing could be speaking extemporaneously, which is like an extempo that you have, right? Again, speaking instantly while you're given a chance to speak. So when we talk about outlining how are we going to go about becoming a better public speaker, we must make sure that you gather your material. When I say gather your material, make sure you try and have examples in your speech, you have a good statistical information, and you have certain testimonies that tell you about their experiences on a particular topic. To state that, I would like to give you an example of certain famous speeches and public speakers, and please observe while you watch the video that how are they using their hand gestures, non-verbal communication, how are they using the lectern, where are they keeping their hands, and we shall discuss that in further.
So in love with you. This is your victory. Now, I know you didn't do this just to win an election. I know you didn't do it for me. You did it because you understand the enormity of the task that lies ahead.
But my main message is to the parents of Trayvon Martin. You know, if I had a son, he'd look like Trayvon. They had their entire lives ahead of them. Birthdays, graduations, weddings. Kids of their own. Among the fallen were also teachers, men and women who devoted their lives to helping our children fulfill their dreams. So our hearts are broken today.
It's the idea held by generations of citizens who believe that America is a constant work in progress, who believe that loving this country requires more than singing its praises or avoiding uncomfortable truths. It requires the occasional disruption, the willingness to speak out for what is right, to shake up the status quo. That's America.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
Facts, evidence, reason, logic, an understanding of science, these are good things. These are qualities you want in people making policy. Black, white, Latino, Asian, Native American, young, old, gay, straight, men, women, folks with disabilities, all pledging allegiance under the same proud flag to this big, bold country that we love. That's what I see. That's the America I know.
Obama out.
So what are the essential qualities that you noted in the video? You must make sure that while you are trying to make an attempt to become a good speaker, would you directly go up and say that your audience should keep quiet? Not really. What you would want to do rather is that your speech should be effective enough that your audience themselves choose to pay attention to you and they are all ears to you. So for that, you would have to establish an eye contact. You must remember that there is a very clear possibility of knowing that how many words can one individual process in a minute, and that is known as lag time. Okay, so when I talk of lag time, any slow speaker who speaks very slowly would actually process the words, which are 80 to 90 words per minute. An average speaker would utilize 100 to 150 words per minute, and fast speaker, like if in case I go on speaking too fast right now, up to 170 words per minute, you might be able to process that many words in a minute. Now, an average person can actually go, the possibility of how many words can you listen to, you can actually listen to 450 to 600 words per minute. And how much are we listening? Have we ever paid attention to that fact? I hope that from next time onwards, you will make sure that you try and process the information and observe whether which category do you belong to. You belong to a slow speaker category, average speaker category, or fast speaker category. So when we think five times faster, we can also talk that fast. There are examples here for which you can actually observe the way and the tone in which the speaker is speaking.
The truth is, you don't have anything to give that you don't have. So you have to keep your own self full. That's your job. You know, one of my daughters is here today from Oprah Winfrey Leadership Academy. Stand up today so everybody can see you. You're going to end your first year soon. Oh my God, it's first year. I say to my girls all of the time that your real work is to figure out where your power base is and to work on the alignment of your personality, your gifts that you have to give, with the real reason why you're here. That's the number one thing you have to do, is to work on yourself and to fill yourself up and keep your cup full. Keep yourself full. Now, I used to be afraid of that. I used to be afraid, particularly from people who say, oh, she's so full of herself. She's so full of herself. And now I embrace it. I consider it a compliment that I am full of myself. Because you only when you're full, I'm overflowing, my cup runneth over. I have so much to offer and so much to give. And I am not afraid of honoring myself. You know, it's miraculous when you think about it. First of all, for me, my father and mother never married. They had sex one time underneath an oak tree because she was wearing a poodle skirt in 1953. And my dad, to this day, says, I want to know what's under that skirt. That's what I want to know. He wanted to know what was under the skirt. They didn't really have a relationship. She wanted one, but, you know, he went under the skirt, and then that was it. And one time, under the oak tree, bam, Renaissance.
Woman is born. It happened there.
That's why I know my life is bigger than that. My life has to be bigger, as yours is, bigger than a moment, than a poodle skirt. It's much bigger. The design, the reason why I'm here is much bigger than, oh, I think I want to see what's under there. So the ability to take care of that, to honor yourself and that which is greater than yourself, that which was the reason for your being here, that there's no selflessness in that. Because only through that do you have the ability to offer yourself, your whole self, your full expression of who you are to the rest of the world.
be the guidelines for being appropriately dressed when you are wanting to become a public speaker? Should we pay attention to that perspective as well? It does make a very significant part of your personality, because while you go on the stage, your presence matters, and your presence matters not only because of your words, but also because of how you look. So you make sure that in your clothes you avoid the wrinkles. You should in fact dress traditionally. Whichever country you're going to, try and make sure that you have your brand that is being represented by you. What kind of principles do you hold for yourself? Okay, wear a dress or a business suit if in case it's an official meeting for which you are going to be delivering a talk. Your pocket should always be empty, because otherwise you're going to fiddle with the things, with the objects that are kept in your pocket. So that should not happen. Leave your handbag at your seat if in case, and this is to all my dear ladies, whenever you are invited to speak, please make sure you're not carrying your bag along. Then use of color, you know, for the official meetings, it is suggested that you must use colors like blue, gray, not too bright while you are speaking, because the color also could be distractive while you are performing. Your necklines, please make sure that you have all the buttons nicely put up of your shirt. If in case it is about women, that you should be decently dressed. Tailored look gives you more authority when you speak on the stage. You want to own the stage. And how do you do that? You do that with your dress code as well somewhere. And make sure you're choosing comfortable shoes. You do not want to go up and down while you're speaking on the platform, on the lectern. You do not want to show that you're uncomfortable by moving back and forth, right? So here is another video which tells you about what kind of colors should be better for you. How should you dress appropriately?
As a communications trainer and personal stylist, my participants often ask me, what should I wear for my presentation? Everyone's going to be looking at me, so I want to look good, but I've got to feel comfortable and confident. Hi, I'm Sharon Tabois with Lighthouse Communications. Let's talk about the 3 C's to remember when deciding what to wear when presenting. The first C, culture. Consider the culture of your audience or company. Will you be presenting at a corporate, business casual, or less formal environment? If you work for a company where a t-shirt and jeans are the norm, consider wearing a dark wash pair of jeans and a button-down shirt, or even a polo shirt in your company's color to amp up the look. The second C is color. Do you have a color that when you wear it, you immediately feel more confident? Or maybe you even have a signature color. Or it could be that color that when you put it on, even strangers around you comment on how fantastic it looks on you. If you don't have such a color just yet, consider your hair color, your skin complexion, and your eye color when deciding what looks best on you. Try experimenting with jewel tones like ruby red, because they look flattering on most all complexions. If you know that there's a strong possibility that you're going to sweat when you're nervous in front of your audience, opt for either extremely light or extremely dark colors. Also consider the fabrication of your garment. Choose something natural and absorbent like cotton. That way, potential pit stains or sweat marks will not prevent you from gesturing freely when you want. If you know that you're going to be recorded, opt for wearing solids as opposed to prints. Yeah, I am wearing a bold print right now, so bold prints are okay, but you do want to stay away from really fine lines, thin pinstripes, because they could create a moiré effect on camera. Check out the 2 links below for more information on what to wear and what not to wear when you know you're going to be filmed. The final C is comfort. You want to make sure that you're choosing clothes that fit comfortably, properly, and are also flattering for your body type. Imagine how uncomfortable you could be if you wore something that was too restricting or something that was too loose that it was falling off your shoulder. In addition to being very distracting for your audience, it can also prevent you from really being able to focus on your content, which is the whole reason why you're there. It's pretty common to get warm when presenting, so it's a good idea for you to have a finishing layer that you can easily remove in case you get hot. Finishing layers are things like a cardigan or a blazer, but you want to make sure that you don't have too heavy of a finishing layer that will prevent you from being able to gesture easily in those moments that you want to add impact to your content. Definitely put some thought into which shoes you're going to wear when presenting. We walk a little bit differently with each pair of shoes, so be sure that the shoes that you choose will allow you to feel stable and grounded. Ask yourself, Will I rock in place with discomfort because these are new shoes that I haven't broken in yet? And ladies, if you're choosing to wear heels, make sure the heel height isn't too high for you to be able to maintain a confident posture for the entire length of your presentation. So there you have it, the 3 C's to remember when deciding what to wear when presenting. These 3 C's will really help you to feel more confident walking into that next high-stakes situation. If there are other factors that you have, feel free to comment down below. Happy presenting.
Now, while we talk about dressing up appropriately, we have talked about how we should focus on our speech. Should we also talk about the audience? We must analyze our audience as well. So in the video that we had on effective speaking, I talked about how do you connect with your audience. But should we be also thinking about what kind of strategies can we use to connect with the audience? We must make sure that we tell them stories, share your personal experiences in your speeches. That is the best possible way in which your audience will instantly connect with you, because you know, after all we are talking about is human experience. Be aware of your target audience. Know their age groups. Know the energy in the room. Many a times you've seen that there are people who are very happy, they are enthusiastic, they are smiling, they are clapping. They are very much aware of what you're speaking, what your content is. They are with you, on the same page. So know the energy in the room. You must also be willing to poke fun at yourself, because humor and wit are certain aspects of speech pattern wherein you can instantly connect with the audience. That is also a strategy that you could use. If a class is going if something serious concern is going on, that's the best way in which you could catch the audience attention, right? So work on your nonverbal body language as well. That's how you will be able to connect with the audience. There are various kinds of audience that you might find in the hall, but you must adapt as a speaker towards how will you connect, what kind of strategy will work with these kind of audience. They should not look dull. So while you are using a podium, firstly, let me tell you, a podium is very different from a lectern. When I talk about podium, it is a raised platform. And what you see there on the screen, the gentleman standing there, that is called lectern, right? So do not put your hands on the lectern. That is not good. Do not lean on it. There are times when you see that the person is almost like falling on it, right? Do not do that. And check the height of the lectern as well, if it matches your height or not. When I talk of the height of the podium as well, that is the surface, raised surface in the classroom. If in case it is too raised, you must make sure that if you can establish eye contact with the audience is possible or not, those kind of possibilities should be checked. While using the microphone, please do not use a handheld mic, because half your possibility of using hand gestures is taken away by that. A lavalier or a lapel mic is ideal in all situations. It prepares you and prepare yourself as well, you know, to be loud enough. Adjust the mic before you begin to speak and before you begin the speech, you know, on a tone where your beginning also has to be very, very effective, right? So stand close enough for the benefit of the audience, because if you are too far from the mic, you will not be audible. Don't allow the mic to block the facts. So sometimes you're too close and you're speaking exactly, and then somebody could actually hear your breath as well. That is not how close your mic should be. Be careful with the P sound, th sound, because these are sounds of the words, with all the words that begin with these sounds, they will be very, very loud. They'll be, so you have to make sure that certain words, there could be a session that you would have in sometime soon, where we'll talk about pronunciation as well. So please refer to that. And as much as possible, be careful with what kind of sounds are being spoken, because on the mic, these sounds will have air effect as well. Beware of other noises as well that are around you. On the basis of that, we further move to talk about what could be the ideal purpose of your speech. So your speech should persuade, your speech should inform, and your speech should also entertain people, right? They can be taken up separately, but one speech could also have these 3 purposes well together. So when you want to speak, What is it that is required? You require your interest, you require expertise and the value. So please try and ask yourself, whatever topic you are choosing, is it going to be interesting for you to develop content on that? How is it going to benefit others? How is it going to add value to their life? Why should they listen to you? When you ask these questions to yourself, you will better prepare yourself and your speech will have all the possible do's and don'ts kept in mind, and it will be a nice performance being a public speaker. Then I would want to talk about organizing the ideas. So there are various strategies that you could use while you want to organize. There are patterns of speeches. First could be the chronological pattern. You could choose a time frame. You could look at historical facts and how it used to be in the history. For example, if I talk about the attires that we used to wear, that our parents used to wear. So in that speech, I will cover up that how my grandfather used to wear a dhoti kurta, and then from there they move to wearing the pants and trousers, and to present day world where you have actors like Ranveer Singh as well experimenting with the choice of menswear, right? So that could be a chronological pattern, and it could be descending and ascending both. Then you have spatial pattern, where it could be related to the geographical space. So you might move, if you are trying to give me an accumulated information about what is happening in India and the culture that we follow. Say for instance, in Punjab you have Fulkari, that is famous. In Rajasthan it is some other kind of bandhani that is famous. Then you have Kalamkari, several other kinds of fabrics that are famous. So you are locating it, that information is based on the basis of geographical space. Then casual pattern could also be there, where you are flipping, you are talking about the causes that are there, what leads to cause and effect relationship that you could have. And you could also use a mixed pattern of speech as well. Problem solution pattern. So you have a problem in India that we have too much poverty, and solution, what could be the possible solutions for it? You could also have a topical order pattern. So you have a topic and then subtopics and subheadings that could be there for it. What is of the most important significance for you? You could talk about employment, how there is unemployment in our country. What are the possible strategies that the government is using in order to increase the employment facilities? What age group are they targeting? So those are subheadings of unemployment, right? So while you're talking about organizing the ideas, please make sure you are organizing the message firstly, you are creating an introduction, then you are composing the body of your write-up, and then you give it a complete closure and write the conclusion as well. But while doing this, please make sure you keep the purpose and the audience both intact in your mind. So while you have to deliver the speech, what are the things that you should avoid? You should avoid all possible signs of nervousness while you are delivering it, right? So fidgeting is the first thing that comes to mind. Please make sure that you're not playing with the jewelry. It'll be very distracting. You would not like, because you are the face there. All the audience are paying attention to what you're speaking. So while you're at the lectern, please make sure you use your hand gestures. Your hands are not, you're not falling on the lectern, and you're not playing with the pen or the paper that you've taken on the lectern. Pacing. So when I talk about pace, some people, give a talk, deliver a talk like in a TED talk. You get a stage. So if you move back and forth and on with a speed that people will not be able to concentrate, when I want to listen to somebody, I want to see you. I want to be able to know what kind of voice modulation you are having. So your pace is very important. And when we talk about pace, it's not the physical movement alone. It is also how you are speaking. If I speak too fast, you will not follow me. And if I speak too slow, you might get bored. So the pace of speech also has to be maintained. Then there are a lot of people for whom the hands are shaky. So your hand should not shake. If you want that your hands are very shaky and you shiver, and then in that case you could use hand notes, you could use the cards that could be there to assist you, right? Develop your good body language in order to avoid any of these signs of nervousness. Make sure that you have eye contact and engage with people. So when I talk about effective public speaking techniques, what are the things, possible things that we could do? We have to make sure that we care about the topic that we are going to be talking about. Remember, what is your speaking goal? The very topic, you should not divert and digress from that topic, the title that you have chosen for your speech. Support the very main points that you have. Write down the keywords. Tell a story. So your clients, your company's story, the product development story that you have, any of those, you know, while you talk about telling a story about the university, how it was established, to why is it that tourism industry could be important for you. All of those stories will help you connect with the audience. Use the presentation tools very wisely. Make sure that you are adding the audio and video. In this video lecture as well, you saw that there are audio and video both that have been used. So, and construct a timeline as well, you know. So by doing that, it will be the quality of the effective public speaking. For this, you can also refer to TED Talks, where most people are utilizing the all possible PPTs, and how are they designing them. Observe that. Use a professional template. Do not use informal language there on the screen when you are going to be talking about effective public speaking. Each word for your PPT also will be noticed by people. My suggestion would be that you use the standard format, which is Times New Roman font. For your presentations, right? And relax. The most important part is that just before your speech delivery, you must meditate or exercise or have a positive affirmation. The best thing that you could do is you could also utilize aromatherapy. You could put some nice smell and put some nice music as well, if in case that eases out your nerves. Then what could be the possible effective speaking techniques? You do not need to worry about the mistakes. All of us are in the process of learning. So even if in case there are mistakes, you will be able to manage it. Just move forward, pace yourself. Add visual aids, dress comfortably, but professionally. Avoid saying like, because that is very distracting. Go on speaking. Don't say, this is what I want to say. So after every word, sometimes some people intend to use it again and again, right? That's not the quality of a best public speaker. Use gestures, but doesn't mean that you become dramatic, right? Allow question and answers. Please make sure that this is another technique where you receive feedback from your audience. To complete the communication cycle, you need those question and answer rounds towards the end of your speech. Be open to it. And on this note, I hope that you will remember you are much better speaker than you thought you were. And we look forward to hearing from you at public platforms soon. Thank you.